Hello, everyone. My name is Susan Gantt, and I'm the director of the System-Centered Training and Research Institute. And welcome to the System-Centered Training YouTube video site. And we're very pleased to have this site, which gives us a chance to put out some of the information about System-Centered Training. First of all, it was developed by von Exerian, and System-Centered came from her theory of living human systems. Now that's a mouthful, theory of living human systems, and if we break it down, it's a way of seeing either a person as a living human system, or a couple or a marriage as a living human system, or a family as a living human system, or a team, whether it's a work team or a sports team, is also a living human system, or even the whole organization, or even if we really get the lens out big, the whole of a nation. And so a theory is a way of seeing something, and this theory starts with the assumption that the system, the living human system, has more to do with how we can function as human beings than just ourselves and our own resources, and the system has more to do with it. And if we take that for granted, then we really start to pay attention to how do we influence the systems that we're part of so that they then influence us in ways that we can thrive more as human beings. And that is the part of system-centered. Now, if we think of this idea, one way to think about it is to think about going back to visit your family of origin with a holiday. And hopefully some of you will feel the same way I did. But as soon as I go back into my family, I start behaving and even thinking sometimes in ways I don't think in my ordinary life. And that's the impact of the family system. And that happens wherever we are. Whatever system we're in is going to influence who we are and who we can be at that moment. The taking that to heart has led System Center to then develop methods for how to influence the norms of systems in a way that the people in them can thrive more easily. And the central idea we work from for that relates to differences, with the idea that to the extent that we can take in differences and relate to differences, then the systems we're part of will, in fact, develop, change, and innovate. And that is really also the source of creativity, being able to take in differences. And as human beings, we are unfortunately very challenged about taking in differences, and that's really true at the level of our brain biology. Our brain is built that we react to differences that are too different, as if they're threats, and we can't help that. That happens all the way through our body. When we get a difference that's too big for us, our body has a reaction. So what System Center does is pays attention to how do we create the conditions in the system that will enable us to manage our reactivity and then be able to relate to the differences and use them instead of reject them or just react to them. That's really the beginning video to go to from here, is to watch the video on functional subgrouping, because that is the SCT method for how to work with differences. And that will give you the heart of SCT right at the very beginning. And the second video I would recommend is the theory Introduction to System Centered by von Exerian. And from there, I would recommend exploring any of the ones that catch your eye, whatever gets your curiosity, whatever you're interested in. And remember, as you're watching, have fun, follow your curiosity, see what you discover. And just one small tip, the video on some of the tapes is not so good, but the audio on all of them is good. So feel free to even listen and not watch if that helps. And thank you for tuning in.